Merci, mon ami. Allez, oui. Bon chien.
Victory had a bittersweet taste for Anna. Carl, seriously wounded, had been sent to a POW camp. Anna's father had disappeared with Baron von Dorf, and Emil was court-martialed for desertion. Cited for his bravery in Reims, Emil was fortunately pardoned and set free. Free to go back to the front. February 21st, 1916. Winter had descended on the front. After joining back up with the army, Emil and Freddy were stationed near Verdun, suffering like many others from the harsh winter. That morning, the arrival of the mail raised spirits, but Marie's letter did not bring good news. In Saint-Mihiel, food was scarce, disease was rife, and the number of dead was growing. Out of this grim news, however, there was one ray of light. A photo of his grandson, Victor, standing on both feet and learning to walk.
Don't worry.
Merci, Walt.
What?
Alors,
pas de boule, pas pour toi. Pas de brignole pour toi, le bigorneau.
Allez, oui.
My dearest daughter,
I heard from Carl. His condition is stable. He is still in the prisoner camp south of Reims. I hope to finally get permission to visit him. Thank you for the photo. It means so much.
Come on, boy. Heidi!
Yeah.
precision cannon firing enabled Freddy and his regiment to reach the rear line unharmed.
Bravo, Freddy!
Bill, thank you very much.
The military hierarchy heard of their feats in battle and decided to decorate the two friends for their bravery. Emil received good news from Anna. Carl was recovering nicely. He was even walking again. Meanwhile, the battle for Verdun only grew longer and bloodier. The death toll was staggering, 70,000 per month. Almost one Frenchman and one German every minute, and it went on for 10 months, day and night. May 8th, 1916, Emil's squad was sent on a mission to take back Fort Douaumont, a strategic point in the German defense.
Thank you. Hey, my brother.
Hey, get out.
know.
Come, come, come.
Despite the fort's partial destruction, the Germans held their position. The mission was a failure.
My darling, war has taken away a very dear friend. He was like a brother to me, and his death affects me much more than I could imagine. In happier news, Carl is safe from the trenches, and his condition improves steadily. I'll go and see him on my next leave. And what about you? How are you? Are things in Saint Miel any better?
Carl discovered things were not, in fact, any better. According to Marie's last letter, his son had fallen gravely ill. Carl had come to a decision. This war would never end. He had to escape.